Make sure to like the video, subscribe to the channel, and turn on the notification bell so you never miss an update.
Was there anybody that was equal to me as far as talent, being aggressive, being vicious, or any of these things? It would have to be a person that possibly played college football, that or even pro football, that had that intensity, that had that will to win. Maybe somebody that might have been an Army Ranger or in the Navy SEALs. It would have to be somebody of that caliber to even tickle my feathers, you know. Everybody else was it was just another walk in the park. But I liked a good tough match, and I only had a couple of them in my 25 years of wrestling, and both of them were against myself.
This guy here was actually one of the first heels I ever cheered for, because he was the first really nasty double cross I saw when he clotheslined Hulk Hogan at the end of a tag match and then gave him a pile driver. And that's Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff.
They ended up carrying him out in a stretcher after I pile drove him. And I would say from that time on, and that was, you know, I like that because I like hurting people to start with. And doing that for him and just to teach him a lesson, you know, a lesson that his mama and daddy should have done a long time ago, and I had to do it.
Yeah, he's built more like a fucking truck than he is a human being. And even when he was getting on in his career and had a semi-atrophied arm and was wearing flip-flops, he still took a fight to Leon White and got the better piece of the stick in that deal, which is saying something.
I see Paul, and I'm coming down the hallway, and this was at center stage. In the back of center stage, the stairs in the back of the hallway, you could see them go like this, and they had these big wooden boxes that they had production stuff in. Paul says, "Get out there, you gotta get out there now," and Vader went like that, and Paul turned and he bear pawed him, boom, in the face, and grabbed Paul as Paul was going down in front face locked and shoved him in the box. Well, I know Paul Orndorff forever, before he was wrestling, and as they pulled him aside, everybody wanted to hold Paul back. I said, let them straighten this thing out. Paul went over with his bad arm and hit him right on the chin.
And it was nothing. It was that weak right hand. And he hit me a second time, hit me a third time.
I love you. I hope you live another 50 years. I'm praying for you. But when he says that the bad arm hit him and didn't hurt him, when Leon White came out of that room, his face looked like it exploded.
I drug him down with me. And Paul, some of the wrestlers helped Paul up, and he kicked me once or twice before I got up.
Vader fell on his knees, and Paul field-goaled him right on the chin, and his head actually touched his heels, okay? Now everybody's mulling around. They push Paul into one of the dressing rooms. Vader, I gotta give him credit. He came in and said, let's go.
I remember that, and I got up and grabbed him, and we went into the coach's room, fighting like a wrestling-type fight. But that was it.
And Ming stepped in and said, no, nothing's going to happen. Both of them.
Ming came up behind me and said, Leon, that's enough. You're going to hurt him. And at that point, I didn't want to mess with Ming because that would have been a mistake, I think.
I'm not saying that Leon's not a tough guy. I'm not saying that he doesn't remember it the exact way it happened, because memory's a funny thing, you know? You like to remember different things different ways.
He had boots on. And, like, you know, I don't know why that matters, but I guess if you're barefoot and slippers on, it's harder to fight somebody, right?
No. He was wearing flip-flops.
He was.
Okay.
He was wearing flip-flops.
And shitty fucking 99-cent with the where your toe gimmick has just that ball that comes through. I mean, not flip-flops. I'm talking shitty 99-cent shower shoes.
And he dropped them.
Like twice.
But it was, I'm late, so what's he doing with slippers on? He's an agent. He's got his boots on.
Paul Phil Golden, but if he had cowboy boots on,
it would have been over.
It would have been over. It was over anyway. Yeah. I mean, his face was all swelled up.
I mean, and then the next day, how Paul had beat me up, and what they're seeing is those three hits to the face, and I mean, it was like, It was like my 12-year-old son hitting me in the face.
There was, Orndorff must have got him right in the right place. His whole face, not only his nose and his cheeks, his whole face looked like it exploded. You ever see like the gray and black bins that they would put like ice in, put water in so that you get, he threw all the water out of one of those bins. It was just ice and melted ice. Held his breath probably for about 15 minutes and would go under, you know, to try to get the swelling to go down. So, Leon, I love you, but when you said he didn't hurt you, your face looked like it exploded. I'm sorry. That's just the truth. I was asked to tell you the true story, and that is the true story as I seen it.
You don't stop right there. You know what? Paul has made a living talking about this night. And he, one of the things he says, and you know what? I understand Paul's sick. I guess he's got throat cancer, is that right?
Yeah.
So, you know, it's hard to say this, but, you know, I was there that night.
I don't know what else there is to say other than he got his ass whipped. And if that's what you want to hear, fine. If he thinks he won, that's fine. I don't really care. I don't care. It don't matter.
I like the fact that the next day he went on national TV and he said to talk about toughness, because he pretty much just broke character and just said toughness is that he gave an interview and he just said, but that's when you take an 800-pound gorilla and you just punch him in the face and you knock him on his ass. And he was just that Mr. Wonderful doing a shoot type interview, because that had just happened, I guess, you know, the day before or what have you. But man, I tell you, Paul Orndorff, I had heard that name when I first moved down to Florida so many times, because he was known as the Brandon Bull. He was such a hell of a football player and wrestler in high school, and he played for the University of Tampa, the Bulls, I think they were. And he was just a bull of a man. He was a man built like a boy or a young boy, an 18-year-old built like a fucking man back in the day. And I'd always heard legitimate, you know, stories about Paul. Don't fuck with Paul, you know. And if you want to check some of these guys, there's a couple of YouTube videos out there. I guess Tony Atlas does an interview. I can't remember it as Tommy Rich. I don't know what he admits to and doesn't.
The later 80s and 90s kind of a blur to me, man.
When they come up this way, I guess Tony ran his mouth a couple times and Paul just said, you know, hey, pull the car over.
Oh man, it was Orndorff, Atlas, because I just traveled Tony Atlas. But anyway, I guess there were three guys in the car. There was a disagreement and Orndorff and Atlas pulled over on the side of the road and was going to fight it out. And they got into it and Paul bit part of Tony Atlas's ear off. And Tony missed a couple of shots for it. And I think Watts fined him for missing the shots because Paul had bitten his ear off. And that's just the way it was back in the day.
Legitimate badass, man. That's just not someone you... And I say this, when you talked about doing the pile driver too, when Hogan, but I mentioned it in my top 10. We did our top 10 moves and holds in pro wrestling. We had the pile driver at the top of the list. Paul Orndorff had one of the best. And I know we're talking, you know, shoot fighting and street fighting, this and that. And you probably, you know, not going to get a guy in a position in a street for a pile driver. But man, he had one of the best pile drivers in all professional wrestling, man. It was just, he had that jumping pile driver.
Yeah, his looked like it would break your neck.
You know, nowadays, if you talk to a wrestler, if they do an interview with him, the first thing they come up is, what's your gimmick? Or you're this gimmick. Well, you know, that's what was so unique and different about me. First of all, I didn't have a gimmick. The gimmick I had was me. That is truly me, the way I acted. The intensity, to be ferocious, to be aggressive. When a guy's down, I kick him. I kick him harder.
Order Pin Me, Pay Me, Have Boots Will Travel by professional wrestler Bobby Blaze Smedley. Go to Amazon.com and get your copy now. It's a powerful and insightful 5-star memoir available to download or in paperback print edition.